Christians around the world are under attack. One third of the world faces religious oppression, and an overwhelming 80% of the oppressed are Christian. This makes Christians the most persecuted religious group. As we stand here today, according to Open Doors US, there are over 360 million Christians who are facing persecution solely because of their faith in Christ. I have been to the borders of war-torn countries. I have sat in the desert camps of people who have been imprisoned, persecuted, killed, and pushed out of their homes solely because of their faith. Their only crime was being Christian. We are witnessing an era where it has never been more dangerous to be a believer in Christ. There is a genocide underway in Armenia. 120 Armenian Christians are facing starvation, gross human rights violations, and being forced out of their historic land in Nagorno-Karabakh or Artsakh. Over 1,000 Christians were slaughtered in Nigeria in the first 100 days of this year alone. The Christian population in Iraq and Syria has diminished by over 80% in just one generation. Christians around the world face imprisonment, loss of their businesses, torture, and even death solely because of their faith in Christ. These Christians around the world have a question. Who will be their voice? Who will be their advocate? Who will protect them? When speaking of genocide and atrocities, President Biden has said time and time again, we recommit ourselves to never again allow an atrocity like this to happen. We are asking President Biden and his administration, where are you now? Where is the United States now as a genocide is unfolding in front of our eyes and Christian persecution is skyrocketing like never before? We are calling upon United States Congress and the Biden administration to keep their promise, to uphold the standard for international religious freedom, to intervene to stop the genocide happening right now in Nagorno-Karabakh or Artsakh, to sanction countries that are led by dictators and terrorists, and to protect Christians around the world who innocently face persecution because of their faith.